I guess I'll start off with a little story that happened the other day. I teach catechism to sixth graders. And the other day I was telling them my vocation story. And after about 20 minutes, which was way too long to tell anything to sixth graders, they started kind of getting antsy. And I was like, are you guys bored? And of course, the three girls sitting in the front row are just like, no. And this kid in the back named Charlie, he just kind of like slouching in his chair and just goes, yes. So I hope I don't bore y'all like I bored Charlie. At the end, I prayed that he would become a priest, which really embarrassed him, so I don't think he'll do it again. So like I said, my name is Brett Metzler. I grew up in Denton, Texas, and went to St. Mark's Parish. That's still my home parish. And I guess the theme of this talk is the quote by Christ, "Whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will save it." As I grew up, I went to Immaculate Conception in Denton, Texas, and I received a great education in my faith. It was a wonderful school, but for some reason in my mind, just still kind of maturing in my faith, I saw the faith as just an obligation. There was kind of a fear there. I mean, I think it was a healthy fear, but there wasn't. I was just kind of doing it because I felt like I had to. You know, it didn't really become my own until later on. And then I went to Liberty Christian High School, which is in Argyle, Texas. And there as well, I received a great education. They're very good at promoting virtue and teaching you how to be good men. And the transition in my faith at that time became more of, I don't want to be afraid of this anymore, and so what can I get out of this? You know, I started thinking, what can I get out of the faith? You know, what can the faith do for me? Which I think was healthier than this kind of fearful approach, but it wasn't enough to really follow Christ like he calls us to. And so after high school, I went on a retreat called Relentless Pursuit. And the retreat master, basically his approach was to get us to see the call and the mission of Christ as something that's about giving your life for Christ. So not do this because you have to, and not do this because it's gonna give you all these great things, and you're gonna be happy and me focused. But do this because it's sacrificing your life for Christ. Because only when you do that will you save your life. And after that, I realized this is what I want to do. I started to understand the sacrificial nature that's required of the call to follow Christ. And after the retreat, I started praying. I started. I would go into my closet and I would sit on the ground and I would say, Lord, I don't know how to pray. Teach me how to pray and tell me what you want me to do with my life. And I did that every day for about 2 months. I was going to daily mass and confession. I wasn't only sitting on my closet floor. I was doing the sacramental life of the church, played the major role. And after about 2 months of that, I went to Texas A&M University. That's right. And 3 weeks into that, I came home and I was driving back. And I remember I was sitting in the car and I was listening to music and I was driving, and all of a sudden I was hit with this intense desire to become a priest and to lay down my life for Christ and his church. It was something I had never thought about before. And at the time, I kind of felt like it came out of nowhere, but now realizing the pattern that my life had started to take, the pattern of laying down my life for Christ and sacrificing my life for Christ, kind of came to its peak in this moment. And throughout the year at A&M, I kept wrestling with this. It started as this intense desire, and over time, it kind of settled down to a thought. And every day, the thought would continue to come up. The desire, the emotions would go away depending on what I ate that day. I mean, they were all over the place. But the thought remained. And over time, I told God, God, if you really want me to do this, show me. You know, make it clear that you want me to do this. And towards the end of that semester, I remember it was finals week, and I picked up a book at 10 p.m. instead of studying for finals, and the book was called Fulfillment of All Desire. And basically, the book is just quotes by the saints about their relationships with God and about what they've done in their lives and how they've given their lives for Christ. And the book just, it inspired me. I read it for 7 hours, and I mean, I was exhausted afterwards, but after I read it, I thought, this is it. This is what I want to do. I want to give my life to Christ. And so I entered seminary in the fall of 2012. I've been in for 5.5 years. And seminary, I was thinking about this analogy yesterday, and I hope that the analogy works. If not, I'm sure the Holy Spirit will correct the analogy for you. But I see the seminary as, I think of the Transfiguration. Some days, seminary feels like we are on the mountain with Christ. It feels like, this is what I want to do. Lord, you know, do you want me to make 3 tents here and we can stay here forever? This is wonderful. I remember I was teaching a catechism class 3 years ago, and this kid in my class named Joshua, he was very rebellious and always kind of talking and laughing and making jokes, and we were always having to tell him to be quiet. And then I gave my vocation story to them, and he came up to me afterwards, and he said, Mr. Metzler, can I have that book that you mentioned in your talk? I really want to read it. You know, I really think I want to follow Christ. I was like, sure, Joshua, but the book is 325 pages. I'll give it to you. And so I gave it to him, and from then on out, his mentality changed. He was into the class, and he followed Christ. And it was in those moments that you're like, this is wonderful. You know, this is what I want to do. I had an impact on this kid, and he wants to follow Christ, and you feel like you're on top of the mountain. But after the Transfiguration, they go down the mountain, and there's immediately an exorcism, which I'm sure was terrifying for most of the disciples. And sometimes seminary feels like that. It's kind of... It's like yesterday I was on the mountain, and now there's a demon in front of me. You know, this is terrifying. But really, there's very few things that I've experienced in seminary that have been terrifying. Very few. I can't name any. It's the terrifying thing is generated in us, and it's generated from the realization of the daunting importance and beauty of the priesthood. And it's something that we think about every day. You know, it's the more we learn theology, the more we get to know priests, the more we get to know people, the more we get to know the priesthood, the more we learn about how important the priesthood is. And it can be terrifying sometimes. It can seem like I don't know if I can cast out that demon. You know, I don't know if I can do this, and this in the priesthood. But as the journey goes on, Christ teaches us to trust him. And the more he's done that for me, I can't speak for all seminarians, but the more he's done that for me, the more that the fears have started to subside and the joy of the Christian life has started to come forth. And so that's kind of like the theological side of how some of us experience seminary. Just for practical purposes, the schedule at seminary, at least in Washington, is we have morning prayer and evening prayer. And as a community, morning prayer at 7:30, evening prayer at 5:30. We have mass together every day. We're encouraged to do a holy hour for that personal time with Christ. And then school is basically like the college setting. Sometimes classes in the morning, sometimes in the afternoon. The thing that I think I'm most excited about the priesthood. I was asked to comment on this for my final point. Excited, for one, to be with all of you, to serve you and your families, to baptize your children and grandchildren, to be there at funerals, and to walk with families throughout their lives at the happiest and saddest moments of their lives. I'm excited, most importantly, though, to follow Christ. Like I said, throughout seminary, Christ has taught me to trust him. And the more he's taught me to do that, the more he's taught me that laying down my life will not end in sadness and gloom, but paradoxically will lead to Christian joy, the more I've actually started to believe him. And I think that with that mission and with that understanding, I think it's worth it. I think the priesthood will be worth it, and Christ has showed me that it will be. And so on behalf of all the seminarians, thank you so much for all you do, for your support. I can't express just the tremendous gratitude we have for all of you for making it possible for us to go to seminary and be formed, receiving an incredible education and incredible formation, and it really means a lot to all of us. And so we'll keep you in our prayers, and thank you.